Challenger Elise Gameplay. Welcome everybody to the video. Today we're watching a Korean VOD, actually, of an Elise player who is very high ranking on their server. Elise is very strong in the meta right now, so I thought we might as well just do a VOD review, look over at what the best Elise players are doing and see what we can learn. So far everything looks pretty standard, honestly. We see him starting with Ember Knife, which is pretty common with Press the Attack Elise, which is what he's doing, by the way. His runes are, as you can see here, Press the Attack. I will put the rune page on screen for you guys during this video, so you guys can see that. But he went PTA with Domination Secondary, which is pretty standard right now. PTA is amazing on all these guys, if you didn't know. Going Nashor's 2 second item gives you amazing on-hit damage with your W and Spider Form, which allows you to have fantastic clear. Very weird why he did that. I guess it's so he doesn't get invaded. I like this clear pathing, actually. He goes red buff all the way over to blue. It was very, very interesting, actually. I'm really curious as to what he's going to do next here. So he goes... This is really interesting, because when I play Elise, I actually do a completely different clear. So he goes red buff into blue buff into Gromp to hit that level 3, obviously. Very interesting. So now he's level 3. He's walking over a ward here, which I know he doesn't know. We have Elise over here, guys. Make sure you always look at that mini map. He's going for an invade on Elise. Elise does know that he's coming. And he's just walking right through here. No fucks given. Damn, he's just going for it. Elise 100% knows that she's here. So this invade is not going to go awesome. Never mind, he one-shots Elise. Crazy damage. Hops over the wall. Gets the flash auto attack. Beautiful. This is worth it. Live or die, this is worth it. And he lives. Amazing. That is an amazing start to this game. That is fantastic. Wow. So just to go over that again, guys, this guy starts red buff, blue buff, a Gromp, followed by an invade into the jungle, which Nidalee actually knew he was there, so it was a little bit of a misplay by her, honestly, but it works out. This is happening in high diamond elo. You guys can do this in your games too. Very well played. Just having a very strong understanding of her champion. This is an Elise main, guys, so obviously making it work there. Love it. Absolutely love it. So he does not obviously recall. Elise has fantastic sustain, so he decides to instead get top scuttle followed by wolves into a recall, and Nidalee will of course grab the bottom scuttle here. She'll be taking that, which of course makes sense. She needs something. They're still relatively even in farm even after everything that happened there, which makes sense. Nidalee does have really good clear timing if she's playing correctly, which she is. Aside from that early death, should not have happened, but it's all good. Looks like Alistar is forced out of lane. We have Elise just going straight back to clearing. Okay, really good. Let's see what he does here. It looks like he's going just continuing his clearing. Not going for anything too crazy right now, which is the smart thing to do. You guys should always be doing this in your games, guys. Always prioritize, you know, clearing jungle camps instead of forcing plays. Like, if he goes for mid lane gank right now, it's very unlikely that it'll work out, and then he just misses out on farming two camps in the meantime. He leeches XP off his mid laner, which tilts his mid laner. But here, because Yasuo is pushed, it's obviously okay for him to walk up. So he's going to go ahead and just clear some of that stuff out there. He walks up to that trap. It's fine, though. And he says bye-bye to this ward, pretends like he walked out, seeing if Yasuo overextends, which is fair. But, like you can kind of see, he's kind of wasting a bit of time here. It's more likely than not that this is not going to end in a kill. And you can see now he's been spotted out, and he's going to be leaving. Hits that, Yasuo walks up pretty freely. Elise has no idea where Nidalee is. We do see Nidalee is up here, but Elise has no idea. You know what, for this video, guys, we're going to turn on Fog of War Blue, so that we just see things from her perspective. There is Nidalee. Flash Flay auto by Thresh, that should be a kill. Very good. Mistook by Thresh. Fantastic play, actually. Really good stuff. Wow, I did not expect that damage to come through, actually. Let's look at that again real quick. I did not expect this damage to come through. So she auto Q, auto. Wow, that damage is incredible. Just really understanding. That's the value of PTA right there. The auto Q, auto with the, you know, just insane damage, actually. Very well played. Super high damage. More damage than Electrocute would provide there for sure. No doubt in my mind. Very well played by Elise there. That's really cool. It's very interesting item-wise. First back, Rush Sork Shoes. This is not something you see Elise players do often either. You see the Alternator more so, but instead he goes Sork Shoes and Dark Seal, which I actually like. Gives a nice balance of stats, and you have the snowball potential on assists and kills. This guy just ego played it. He said, I got two kills early, I'm just going to go ahead and ego buy here. Which is completely fair, honestly. When you're that fed on Elise, you want a snowball, so I respect it. Ari going for a very forced dive here. We know Nidalee is boss side right now. Not going to work out, obviously. I stand corrected. These players are insane on the Korean server. Okay, amazing stuff here. So he's going to be pretty much even. Nidalee might actually be a little bit up in farm. But it's okay because he's putting out a lot more pressure. He's gotten the bottom scuttle here, so at least Nidalee does not get that. Goes mid, let's see what he gets done here. Wow, look at that. Press the attack, instantly proc'd. Just a auto, Q auto, guys. You got to do that on Elise. Insta-proc that, press the attack. It's disgusting how quickly it gets proc'd and how much damage you deal. Like, that's insane. I absolutely love PTA on Elise, guys. It feels so good. It feels so, so nice. So he looks like he's wanting to go for a gank top here. They could actually probably dive this fairly easily. Nar did take a tower shot. A little bit of a bait. I actually respect the fuck out of that. PTA damage secures the kill. And the nice thing about PTA, guys, is you're proccing it all the time. Like, it has such a low cooldown. You're just proccing it 24-7. So now we can kind of see Elise wants to maybe go for this. Indeed, Elise does. That's really good. I don't think the enemy team has any form of vision. We do see Alistar here. So this is going to be a nice little clear here. Onto the Scuttle Crab. Just press the attack on Elise. Just absolute wonders, guys. It's so strong. Okay, Nidalee does spot her. Elise gets it, though. Ember Knife is now completed as well. Looks like Nidalee is running out. That's completely fine. Okay. Really interested to see what transpires from this here. Okay, gets a smite off there. Respect. Gets it. And yeah, he's still even with farm on Nidalee. 54 to 54. Very nice farming. This Yasuo is incredibly farmed. 10 CS a minute at 9 minutes is incredible, guys. This guy is obviously a very strong player. We do not know who he is. The top Elise Korea, guys. The best Korean Elise player. Very strong player. Very active on the map. Very nice and aggressive. Goes for the early invades. I love the clear path this guy had here at the start here. Going red buff, blue buff, romp, invade straight to the red buff. Very simple yet very effective. Absolutely love it. By the time this guy is done with the invade, his scuttle is spawning. I believe he must do this consistently. There's no way he does not do this kind of play consistently. It just looks so clean. It works so well. I mean, with Elise, you can practically do that against anybody. There's very few champions that can duel you early game when you're playing Elise. Especially with press the attack. All right. And that's going to be a dead tower. Very nice use of the rift there. he just was looking around the map. He looked at whichever tower had two plates left, because that's how many plates the Herald will take. No matter what plate it's on, it'll always take two plates. And when the plates go away, it takes about 70% of the tower's health. So he just goes and takes those two plates and then walks away with that extra gold and gives Gnar a huge lead over Garen. This guy's just really snowballing lanes, doing his job as a jungler very, very efficiently. There is a bit of a gap in the mid lane, though, so that's what's going to make this game difficult. We will see how this game transpires. He dodges out on the Yasuo's Q there. Very nice gameplay by him. Huge stuff there. We have Alistar going in, knocking up the Thresh. It looks like Elise is just saying no, do not fight. Elise is now staying on the way. It's coming down. We're going to see they're looking for a dive here. Interesting. We don't really know where Nidalee is. Nidalee's blue buff is spawning, so he has to be here somewhere. We see a Yasuo here now. This is very risky in my opinion, but he seems to be completely fine to do this. We hear Yasuo on wolves. So that must be how Yasuo's maintaining such a huge amount of CS. He's been taking... Oh, we saw Nidalee briefly. Okay, so now we know Nidalee is definitely boss side. Ahri's playing it back, playing safe, getting kind of gapped, but it's okay. Bot lane and top lane are doing well, so Ahri understands this and is playing back. You should always do this, guys. If your side lanes are doing well, just play safe. Don't give up kills. Do not give them an advantage, and you'll win the game most of the time. Okay. Of course, he is rushing the Night Harvester here on Elise. This is something you guys should always be doing. This is the best item on Elise by far when it comes to the mythic items. Secondary with this particular build with Presti Attack, you do want to get Nashor's to the second. And that is a rip from the Gnar there. Very unlucky. Let's see what happens here. It looks like he's looking to get the Skull, which makes sense, of course. Okay. There it is. Getting the Gromp now. And we're just continuing to farm here. Nidalee is maintaining even in CS. We can see she has 90 CS and she is right here. So overall very close in terms of farm numbers, but Elise is putting out a lot more pressure on the map. Alrighty, and we do have a fight going down here. Elise is recalling. They get the kill. Kind of an int by Alistar. Good stuff. So Elise backs, he gets a dagger, and he picks up a Night Harvester. Very good back. This will give him a lot of damage. Dark Seal, dagger, Night Harvester. Three stacks on the Dark Seal. So not getting a tremendous amount of value out of that yet, but I'm sure we'll see that change as the game progresses. What do we have happening now? It looks like he wants to go mid. Boom. Okay, easy kill. His team's just carrying him now. This Thresh is playing amazingly. Absolutely incredible gameplay. Takes that for free. It's looking like he wants to group around Herald that's just spawning now. He wants to take that on spawn. Okay. So that's very interesting. He, even with this massive advantage, he is prioritizing Herald over Dragon, which I find very interesting. I think that's very different for most players. I think that potentially actually is very good, because, of course, the massive amount of gold he managed to get top lane with Gnar, if you have winning lanes in solo queue especially, I think getting Herald is very nice. And sometimes it is much better than getting Dragon. One, because you get 100 gold from it instead of 25, and two, the amount of gold you get from towers far surpasses the immediate effects of Dragon in terms of, you know, gold value. I mean, you get a global buff on Dragon, which of course is very nice and helps you snowball, but getting a tower and, you know, like 800 gold with all the plates you get involved in the getting that tower early, plus first tower gold. Like, that's a tremendous amount of gold. It's equal to like 3 or 4 kills, right, total. So obviously that trumps getting a dragon. So I really do like that from this guy. He does put a lot of emphasis on getting that objective, and he doesn't force dragons. Looks like he does, of course, want to get dragon here. It's pretty free because his team has quite the lead. Yeah, so walks in, gets charmed, and the game's over here, guys. Incredible. Yasuo has to flash out, waste that as well, and now they get dragon for free. Yasuo's really the only hope there of red team here. He's incredibly farmed, very, very strong. Very strong, the strongest member by far on that team. But if he gets caught like that, obviously it doesn't matter. They're just going to get dragons, they're going to amass a lead over time. And now Herald's going to be dropped down bot lane, and they're going to just shove this. Love the macro gameplay here. Of course, now since they have pressure because it's a 4v5, he's going to be taking all of Elise's jungle camps, which will now give him a farm advantage over time. They're setting up aggressive control wards. I love this. You should always be doing this, guys. As support players, be setting up these aggressive control wards. As jungle players, be taking the enemy jungler's camps when it's a 4v5 and your team is all in position. If your team is all recalled, obviously do not do it. But if they're in position, go for it. This is a very bad fight for blue. Actually, a little bit of a mini throw, so the game won't be ending here unless Nard is 1v9s. Wow, huge hook by Thresh again. This guy is just hard carrying. I love supports, man. Thresh is such a great champion right now. Do not sleep on Thresh, guys. Such a fantastic champion. You can carry solo queue games with him easily. He just provides so much utility, so much CC, so much damage even, guys. As a support, he just does so much damage. This is fantastic, actually. You love to see this, guys. So they get the tower, they back. They just have such a big lead. They're just raffle stomping the enemy team. And initially, it looked really bad how the fight started. But Gnar made it work. Thresh landed a priority hook on Yasuo, who's doing absolutely nothing with all of his farm. And yeah, it's turning into a Giga Stomp. I love it. Of course, because they just got a couple picks here, everyone's still in position. Elise does take blue buff and Gromp, which just means that Nidalee is going to be even further behind. All Nidalee has to farm now is obviously this and this. So looks like Yasuo just took the Krugs there. And yep, we see Elise going back into the jungle now. Very excited to see how he closes this game out here. This is Korean solo queue, so I'm not sure. This game is definitely over. Elise, it's very snowbally as well. And there it is. Huge play by Narigat again. The solo kill on Nidalee, who got very pissed off and just walked into the enemy jungle because she had nothing to farm, and you know, we had Yasuo farming that shit, so it's understandable that she would make that play. Wow, she just goes for the fight on Garen here. Look at that damage, guys. She doesn't even have Nashor's Tooth completed yet. She almost one-shots Garen. And guys, Garen almost has like a couple items here. He's not super far behind in gold or anything, right? Very close to gold in Elise, actually. So that is very impressive, actually. Very, very impressive. How much damage she gets dealt there. She does die for this play here. Let's just rewatch this a little bit, guys. Let's jump back in 50 seconds. So it looks like she gets tower aggro. No, she just gets one shot by Garen, actually, which is fair. Completely fair there. It's a little bit of an overextension. I mean, overall, it's not horrible. I mean, they do get the top tower here with minions, right? And obviously, they can't really continue this push anymore. Ahri kind of overstaying here. She gets out. But yeah, we're just going to see a reset from the team. A little bit of an overcommit there. But it's okay, it happens. Everyone makes mistakes, even Korean challenger players. So we're seeing the reset here from Elise. Not quite Nashor's completed yet. And this game might end before she even gets Nashor's. She just has the components, the extra attack speed, very good ability power. The thing about Nashor's that's so nice is it gives 100 ability power and like 60 damage on hit plus, sometimes even more. So they're going for Baron here, actually. saw a lot of pings come out. They actually have an incredible amount of DPS. Aphelios is very strong right now. So they just get this. The enemy team can't even contest it. I don't even know if they... I guess Garen was bought without teleport, so they're thinking he should be pretty free. They have no wards here. They knew that. They need a control ward, so they just go for it. Very awesome. I wonder if Elise made the shot call there. Okay. And we're seeing a recall. What did we see here? Nash is completed. Nice. And now she's running straight to Dragon, guys. Always be on top of those Dragon timers. We can see Dragon is spawning shortly here. So you want to be there. 15 seconds to spawn right now. She's going to be there in just the nick of time. Got to ping your teammates, too, guys. Make sure you ping them. Like, hey, guys, Dragon, Dragon, Dragon. Let's get this. Elise is running over there. You want to be on these on spawn every single time, guys. And he's going to clear out the Scuttle Crab to get that bonus MS. Movement speed, and then get the Dragon, of course. The team is just pressuring mid lane, so the enemy team does not walk up and try and trade. And try and steal Drake here. Respectable play. We have a pick trying to be a pick set up. Elise secures the Dragon. Very solid gameplay here. Just securing all the Dragons. On Elise, you want to do that especially. You want to gather a lead and then get every single Dragon. That's how I play on Elise. I get 4 Dragons by like 24 minutes, 25 minutes around there. And you just win games so easily off that, guys. Oh, that damage from Gnar. Incredible. He gets away with this too. That is some insane damage that he did there. Again, a little cheeky hook over the wall by Thresh there. Gotta respect it. They get the tower. But yeah, you look at this damage. 72 bonus mesh damage on hit. 100 ability power. Like, that is an insane item, guys. Such an efficient item. They one shot. This Thresh is just goated, man. This Thresh is a star player of this game. Landing the most insane hooks. And they have to end here. They have to end here. That is incredible. So you can see Elise did an amazing job. Amazing, amazing job of just snowballing and getting the lead for his team. And Thresh obviously did an amazing job just landing these hooks. But the biggest things to take away is he got 2 heralds, you know. He did his combos perfectly, he pressured the lanes awesomely, he placed down a herald and pushed towers down on the winning lanes. It's really great. It's really great. I think the highlight actually would be his early invade. I think it'll be his early invade. Where he went red buff, blue buff, Gromp, straight into the enemy's red buff and just smurfed on her there, killed her, and got a double kill. That was incredible. Extremely tilted for Garen as a top laner to have to deal with that. That's awesome. It's absolute stellar gameplay here by this absolute smurf. Great stuff. Hey guys, thank you so much for watching this video yet again. I must say thank you. Shout out to all of you guys. Please, 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 if you like the video, put a like there down for me. That would mean the world to me. We've got to get this show into everyone for the YouTube algorithm. Also, leave a comment. Let me know your thoughts on these type of reviews. I want to do more videos like this. I actually enjoyed making this video quite a bit. But let me know how you guys liked it. If you didn't, let me know too. Love to hear all the feedback. Also, please subscribe and join our Discord, guys, where we have a community of active League of Legends players. We're all there to improve, all there to get better and have fun. So if you're wanting to do that as well, make sure to join in there. I will have that in the description. But anyways, guys, thanks again, and I will see you guys in the next video. Peace.